We can start here with the find out the VSWR. So to obtain the VSWR, calculate the VSWR, that is the distance between the half power point is the given. That is about it, 1 mm. That 1 mm half power point is nothing but what? That will be del F. Okay. That is distance between the half power point, that will be 1, that is about a 1 mm. That will be nothing but a del x. That is a distance between the two minima. Because we need to find out a minima first, and then from this we can find out the half power point. So, to calculate the VSWR, we need to know about what will be the guide wavelength and what will be the del x. So del x is nothing but what? A 0.01 centimeter, or you can say that is about it, 1 mm. We can convert it into centimeter or in meter. And then we can calculate that. Okay, so that is about a guide wavelength. We need to calculate the guide wavelength. Calculate the guide wavelength. Lambda g is equal to lambda by under root of 1 minus lambda by lambda. So this lambda 0 is nothing but a lambda c. To price A, that is for the dominant mode. Say that here lambda c is equal to price A, that is for the dominant mode. Dominant mode means what? It is a even. So A is given, that is a 4 centimeter. So lambda c will get directly by 4 centimeter. And then we calculate that a lambda g. So lambda g is equal to what? That is a lambda c we need to calculate. Again, we need to calculate that lambda. And a lambda is equal to what? C by f. That c by is equal to, that is 3 into 10 to the power 8. And a frequency is given, that is about a 10 to the power. So by solving this, we will get the lambda. Lambda will be a solid. And lambda c is equal to twice a, twice into a 4 centimeter, that will be nothing but the 8 centimeter. Lambda is equal to 8. So now we consider that obtain lambda g, we need to put the lambda c, that is the 3 centimeter here. All the values we have written in terms of the centimeter there. So 1 minus lambda, that will be 3. By 8. Okay, that's about the square here. And after solving, we'll get the lambda g. So lambda g becomes what? 3.23 centimeters. That is about our lambda g. Okay, after solving, we'll get the lambda g. Then, using this lambda g, we calculate that. VSWR is equal to what? Lambda g divided by pi so delta x. Lambda g is equal to 3.23 centimeters by 3.14 into delta x. We have delta x is equal to what? 0.1. That's 1 mm. That is about a centimeter. After solving, we will get the VSWR value. That is the endpoint. Okay, simple solid here. We calculate the VSWR with the distance between the half power point is 1 mm. That is 1 mm, that is nothing but a delta s. Assume the wave is in a dominant mode, and given that the dimension of the guide are, that is 4 into 2.5 centimeters, that is A into B. A is the max IL, okay. That is about the width, this is about the height, or A is greater than the B. Automatically you can find out A should be A greater than B. And a frequency is of a 10 GHz. So for that purpose, we need to find out if VSWR is equal to lambda g by pi del x. So lambda g is the guide wavelength. To obtain the guide wavelength, we should know that if the signal is propagating in a dominant mode, it is given. This is nothing but the dominant. Assume that the wave is about the wave is in the dominant mode. So for a dominant mode means what? T10 mode. Dominant mode means what? T10 mode. In that case, the cutoff frequency is nothing but a cutoff wavelength is twice A. Or we can say that it is nothing but a lambda g. So lambda g is equal to what? Lambda by 1 minus lambda by lambda 0. Lambda 0 is equal to lambda c, that is about it twice a, you get that 8 centimeters. And then, and this lambda is nothing but the, what it will be the wave frequency. Frequency of wave is given, that is about it 10 gigahertz. This is about it 10 gigahertz. So lambda is calculated using this 10 gigahertz there, you get the lambda. And then after that, put the, all the values, GSW are there. This is equal to lambda g by pi del x, you get the value. That is about the VSWR calculation. Next is about when and expand slotted line when an expand slotted line is terminated by a short and adjacent null are found at adjacent nulls are found at 9.27 centimeter and 11.05. Find the value of guide wavelength. Now here is the expand slotted line is given. Expand slotted line means what? Expand is about what? 8 to 12 gigahertz. Okay, that is about it slotted. And here it is asking about what? A expand slot line is terminated by a short. When it is terminated by a short, we will get that adjacent null. That adjacent null is nothing but what? X1 is equal to 9.27 centimeter, or we can say that because we get confusion here, D1 and the D2 11.05. So then we have a D1, D2, because we get a null, okay, we get a null, adjacent null, okay, so that is, we have defined, that is a D1 and a D2, right. So lambda g is equal to what? That is nothing but a choice of D1 minus D2 or whichever is higher, D2 minus D2. So guide wavelength, it is about a guide wavelength, that is nothing but a lambda G, it is nothing but, it is about a choice of the distance between the two consecutive minima. Okay, it is nothing but what? A choice of the distance between two consecutive minima. Okay, two conditions. So we'll get that lambda g rise of 11.05 minus 9.27 centimeters. Okay, here we have centimeter there. We get the lambda g 3.56. That is about your lambda g. Next. Calculate that a source is connected to load through a line. And forward and reflected waves are sampled by a directional coupler. Fed to a power emitter as shown in figure. For the mentioned value, or the mentioned value, determine a return loss b magnitude of reflection coefficient. And see, okay, we need to find out for a given particular source. This is about the source we have, and this is that it is connected to the power meter. And that will be a forward direction coupler, we say. And then we say that is here. That is about it. This one is about it, 20 dB. And this is the opposite. That is about it, reflected. Point two. That and if one now here given power meter, this one is the power meter, and if this power meter produces or gives the value, and that values are nothing but what will be the source and a load, and we have a source is connected load through a line, and a forward and a reflected are sampled by the direct coupler. So now this one is about, we can say, a forward wave, okay, reflected wave, likewise. So we can calculate that what will be the incident power there, or a what input we are providing. Okay. So input power, that is nothing but a 20 dB. And the reflected power, that is nothing but a 10 dB. So the output. Okay. So is it done? Forward and this one will be a reflect. Okay, because we have a load, calculate that a forward and a reflect. Now we need to calculate that the incident power. Calculate the incident power. You should know that what will be the incident here, 20 dB. So generally what happened? Power output. Okay. Power output of the source. Or incident power over the line, that is 10 log of incident power by 1 is equal to 20, because it is in terms of a dB. Calculating, you get that 0.20, 0.2, anti log of a 1, that will be of a 2 dB. Okay, we will get the value. Then log of 2, 1, that is nothing but a 100 mV. Then the reflected power, by the load over the line, that is 10 log of VR by 0.2 is equal to, so we will get that VR is equal to 0.2 anti log of 1 is equal to 2 dB. Because if you consider that incident power over the line with respect to what is the input we have. So if you see here, forward and reflected, and power meter gives you the values of 1 meter. 10 log of 1, okay, will get that a power here by 0.2, it's about a 0.2 here, we will get that a reflected value. Then a return loss is RL equal to minus 10 log of the incident one by reflection. Incident, we know that 100 milliwatt and reflected nothing but 2. Get that minus 6.99. Magnitude of a reflection coefficient tau is equal to under root of R by is equal to by 100. VSWR is equal to 1 plus tau get that 1 plus 1.1 that's about your quasi lossless line of 25 ohm when terminated over an unknown impedance two consecutive minima two consecutive minima, voltage minima are 20 centimeter apart with a VSWR of when the impedance is connected replacing the short, the shift in minima is a 6 centimeter towards the load and find the impedance connected to the line in both the cases. So here, if you consider that to obtain the impedance, you should know that ZL is equal to characteristic impedance we have 1 minus we have a reflection coefficient to 1 plus, or we can say that ZO is equal to 1 minus reflection coefficient has a magnitude. Okay. 1 minus 1 plus the impedance. So this a reflection coefficient is nothing but what? That is the SWR minus 1 and SWR plus 1. Since rho is equal to that SWR is equal to 3 given. And phase shift pi plus twice of beta d. Now this d shift is nothing but a shift towards load or a shift towards the, you can say that the source we need to be considered. That is about the minimum. So if you see that D shift here
That is nothing but what? Whatever the shift from the load to the source. Okay. You can consider that shift from the load to the source, or shift toward the load, or shift toward the source. Likewise. So if we consider that it shifted toward the load, because here it is given chart, the shift in the minima is 6 centimeters toward the load, and shift in the minima toward the source. So if we consider that shift in the minima toward the load, then that shift in the minima toward the load is nothing but whatever the we have a shift. So in that case, shift toward the load, that is a minus centimeter, that is this toward the load. You can say that shift toward the load, or you can say that is plus 6 centimeter, that is a shift toward. So we can calculate directly D shift, that is for the toward the load and toward the source, and a reflection coefficient you can calculate here, that is 3 minus 1 by 3 plus 1. Okay. That is about a 2 by 4, that is 0.5. That is so our aim is about to calculate that ZL. We should know that what will be the magnitude here. We get the magnitude, that is about 0.5, and what is the shift. Okay. So our aim is about to calculate that what will be the angle or a phase shift that will be changes. So we should know that what will be the distance between the two consecutive minima. Okay, here it is mentioned that we have a lossless line, 75 ohm. This characteristic impedance, this is the 75 ohm characteristic impedance, 75 ohm. When terminated over an unknown impedance, two consecutive voltage minima are 20 centimeters apart. Okay, two consecutive minima are 20 centimeters apart. So we can calculate that a wavelength, that is about a cutoff wavelength. So this is about a 20 centimeter apart voltage minima. So we will get that lambda c. That lambda c is equal to what? A twice of a, that is about twice of a distance. Okay. That is about a 2 minima twice of a d1 minus d2. So that is nothing but directly lambda c is equal to lambda 0 is equal to 20 centimeters into 2, which is nothing but a 40 centimeters. So if you calculate the phase shift, is equal to twice pi by lambda. Is that twice pi by lambda c or lambda 0? You can calculate that twice pi by, but here we are getting. Okay, we'll get that pi by 20. So we can calculate that theta L here. That is nothing but a pi. So pi plus twice beta of a shift. So pi plus twice of beta. So this D shift is a plus or minus. We can calculate that pi here plus twice of, that is beta pi by 20 into plus or minus. So we consider that